tutorial, we will be experimenting with fonts and OpenType features to create an effective logo in CorelDRAW. Let's begin by typing in the text we want to experiment with. We will be creating a logo for a restaurant named Garden House. A common way of exploring fonts is to copy and paste this text and apply different fonts to see which one looks best. This can be a quite redundant and time-consuming task. There is a much better way to do this, and that is by using the new Font Playground Docker. The Docker can be opened from Text, Font Playground. The Font Playground introduces an easier way to browse, experiment with, and choose the perfect font. You can preview fonts in preset text samples. Or type or paste in the text you want to use. To change the text in all samples, simply double-click on a sample, then type in the new text. We'll change the text to Garden House. Let's use the Docker to view the text sample's appearance in different fonts. We'll go ahead and try out some alternative fonts for the other samples as well. To add another text sample, simply click on Add Another Sample and choose a font from the font list. You can change the order of text samples by dragging a text sample to a new position in the list. Let's move the ones we like to the top of the list. You can also delete a text sample by clicking on the X button at the upper right corner of the sample. We'll delete the one at the bottom of the list. The zoom slider lets you quickly adjust the size of the sample text. We'll move the slider to the right to make the text a bit bigger. You can also change the size in increments by clicking on the zoom buttons next to the slider. There are also several view options for the text. You can view the text samples as a single line of text, multiple lines of text, or you can view a single text sample as single lines of text in increasing sizes. Let's keep it as a single line and make the Docker a bit wider so that we can fit in the whole text. When a text sample uses an OpenType font, you can view available OpenType features and apply them to the sample. Let's highlight the text here that uses Gabriola. You'll notice that it displays the interactive OpenType arrow. When you click on the arrow, you can choose from a variety of OpenType features from the drop-down menu. Let's try Stylistic Set 5. You can make additional changes until you are satisfied with the font. We'll highlight part of Garden and apply small caps to it to put more emphasis on it. Now we will paste the text sample into the document. To do so, click on the text sample and click the copy button. Using the text tool, right-click where you want to place the text sample and click paste. You can also simply drag a text sample to the document window. Now that we have chosen chosen the perfect font, we will continue with the creation of the logo. Let's drag and drop this text sample, Cafe and Restaurant, to the document. We'll resize the text and position it below Garden House, as we want the name of the restaurant to be more prominent. To create more balance with the text above it, we will use the Shape tool to change the inter-character spacing. Drag the interactive handle to increase or decrease the spacing between the characters. We'll adjust the spacing until the text aligns with the text above it. For this, it is helpful to have the alignment guides on. And there you have it, a simple and effective logo created in CorelDRAW. We hope that you enjoyed this tutorial on experimenting with fonts and OpenType features. Be sure to watch the other videos in the training series, including the one that shows you how to create a QR code and embed a logo in CorelDRAW.